Hi everybody, today we start with the shell elements. So we will create a cantilever beam modeled by shell of 1 meter length, apply and close, and we will represent it also rotating it around the X axis about 90 degrees. To have both the possibilities of representing a beam, and we will translate it by half a meter. Then we will create a compound, new entity, build a compound to have the assembly of the two. We will go creating some groups, so here we will go creating the groups where we will put the fixed end. Apply, and here we will put the force. Now we will do a group for the shell vertical and one for the horizontal one. Okay, now we can go meshing it. We'll go the automatic way with the NetGen 1D2D. With a discretization of 10. I want to underline that as we want to use the Kirchhoff element, we need to have first order elements because are the ones that are supported by this modelization. So we will maintain first order elements, and we will now create the group from the geometry. Apply and close, save, and we go to after study. Okay, as always, we create a new stage, read the mesh, mesh one. Now we go assigning the finite element. Here we will give to all the model everywhere yes, phenomenal mechanic. The Kirchhoff element is called DKT, that is a very interesting element also for important functions that are present in CodeAster that we will see in the next episode. So, okay, now AFKRALM, we need to define the characteristics of the elements. COX stands for surfacic elements. We will give the horizontal one first. FAI stands for thickness, so we'll give a thickness of 100. And then there is this vector that is very important because we will go to the documentation where we go vector. Vector is the vector that we can explicitly indicate that will say to CodeAster how is oriented the X local axis in the shell element. So here we want an X direction. We want that the X local is coincident with the X direction. So vector here is 1, 0, 0, the three components of this vector that we want. Okay, now we go for the shell vertical. Okay, API thickness 100. And also here we will specify the vector that is 1, 0, 0. It will be in this direction, the local Okay, so now we have to define material. As always, we'll go for linear isotropic. Okay. Assign the material to all the bodies as always. Okay, now we go to the mechanical loads. First of all, we will go to the fixed boundary condition. So we will select the group we created the beginning, the fixed, okay, liaison incastre to have the fixed boundary condition. Then we have to put the force arrete, that means a force on a hedge, and we will specify the two groups of elements where we want to put the force. In the Z direction, and we will put one that means 1 newton per millimeter. Okay. We go for the analysis, structural element, material field. We go for the boundary condition and loads. Okay. Then we go for a post-processing of a calchamp, reusing the static mechanical, so enlarging this data structure, and we will go for FJ Noeu, that are the general the generalized effort for the element. Okay, and we will go printing all the results. Results, we will go for the calchamp, toothchamp, so that we will print all the fields that are inside the calchamp. We have to specify the name, so we will call it shell.armed, save. Okay, we go for the solution. Okay, so now we go post-processing the data to see. We are shell.armed. Okay, so we will go here, seeing the two elements we created, and we can see the displacement. Most importantly, we can see the normal efforts. For example, here we are on the neutral axis. Here we can see easily the diagram, and the same for the other direction. And of course, it works like always to have the deformed shape. Like that. Okay, I put the value positive, so is in the vertical direction, the deformed shape. It's okay, it's all for today. Let's see for the next episode, that will be very important. Live long and prosper.